Alright, honeys. Well, it was not a good day. I went to the great building supply center store. I went to buy this mortar because I needed more mortar. And I got the mortar, put it in the car. So in the moment of the car putting into, it was really windy. Look at that. Ooh, got makeup on. Okay, it was really windy. And then, oh my God, just as I was lifting the bag and put it right in the back of the trunk, and I was just like right there, the hood, the trunk hood, just fell right bam on my head. So I got a concussion. So it's bleeding like profusely, you know, I'm like, ah. And so my dad is right there, you know, of course he didn't help, you know, he can't, you know, he's just like extra danger plus, you know, and I told him that, you know, you're more danger around in these moments because now the trunk fell on my head. And oh my gosh. And so then I'm driving home and I have the blood pouring down my face. And it was dramatic moments, and I'm like, oh my gosh, as I'm driving, and he's of course yelling at me, you know, like, nah, you should go to the hospital. And I'm like, well, what is the opera? There's a lot of those, the blood drencher operas, because it really was, it was just there on the cake zone until I took a shower, but it was something else. And it's on the back of the car. And so if you had like pulled up right behind me, it would be like, body inside, you know, there's a body inside that car, you know, and in the trunk. So it was kind of humorous. And still, so I went and I looked up immediately. I'm like, okay, what is this part of the brain? And apparently this sector, it's a little bit, it wants to be frontal lobe, but then it pushes back into the motor cortexes a little bit of your right hand, and then the right hand connected to the, what? Yeah, all of that. Those types of, it's analytical thinking. So my analyticals got smacked, and then, oh my God, but I'm okay. I'm all right, like everybody cares? No, I've been cyber bullied by mean, vicious children. And I don't know, I mean, I know it's Nutcracker season, and there are really mean children in the party scene, but that's not necessary. I don't need to be the you know, the bully victim. So I'm like, well, what do? Do I not talk about it? Do I say ignore, you know, it's, do you ignore the cyberbully? And then maybe they go away, they get off their high horse, because they have really vicious children. They're very vicious children, and they're young, they're teens, you know. And I'm like, well, when I was a teenager, I was so polite. Oh my God, I was very polite to elders. I was never ever like a vicious thing, unless of course I've been drinking. But oh my God, maybe that's it. Maybe these children have been drinking. I don't know. So they're doing something that their ego is like overdone. You know, the overdone ego, and they're just so repulsive when their egos are overdone that I don't want anything to do with them. I don't care if they are the greatest in the world at something. They're useless, you know, because they're too horrible. Too horrible to be around or work near, you know what I'm saying? Anyway, so the cyber bullies are really tedious. And I go back to the parent, you know, the parentage. The parents are making these bullies. Like, you know, why bother, you know, they have their little army that they, you know, spawned, and so they have their army, and they allow these children to just run rampant and kind of be hurtful to people, that's all. Anyhoots. So I guess it's cyberbully. Anyway, I'm tired. And I'm not sure, I didn't read if I'm supposed to lie down or just, it's still bleeding a little, if I'm supposed to lay down or sit up, I don't know. I'm gonna lie down, I'm tired. And that's that. I put on my makeup though, yikes, and I got a better lighting. Oh my gosh, a passport photo, it was terrible. I did a passport photo. And they even brought the quality down lower than it has ever been. This was recent. They have taken the toners and really made it just like a hot red. So if you're redheaded, you're screwed because it brings out that rogue red in your face. It brings it out hot. And any shadow here. Like right now I'm trying to get rid of that shadow. Any shadow you have, it just brings it into a big blur. So it was the worst photo ever. So I'm not really sure what happened to the original one I gave them. You know, they decided to throw it out the window and just use this piece of crud because it's like something worse than I would do on my printer. So bad America, because now we're going to go out there around this world with these passports and we look like some like cheap, cheesy, what? Like the bankrupt country of the planet? I mean, it's going to be more and more refusal. Like, excuse me? I don't really know. I mean, who would want you? You look like you have no money. United States looks like it has no money, you know, when it has cruddy photos of the persons that are citizens. Alright. Anyway, back to my hematoma. No, it's not a hematoma. My, what do we call it? Concussion. And that's it. It's that place. Alright, smileys. I'm out.